Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to trace a QR code in Illustrator. Now, that's not a recommended way of doing it. It will be much better if you use tools to recreate it, and there are a lot of tools, web-based and scripts and whatnot. And you can even do it in InDesign, and we are also going to take a look at that. But if you have to, here's how to do it in Illustrator. And first of all, we are going to take a look at how not to do it. So the first impulse would be to go to Window and Image Trace, and then let's just click on Trace. And Illustrator has auto-detected it, and this is what happens. And you see, well, this will not be flying. So that's not going to work. Let's select a different preset. So let's go to Technical Drawing. First of all, you see nothing, but let's turn on the fills and turn off the strokes. And you see Snap Curves to Lines has been turned on, but this is not going to fly either. So these are very, very wonky. So let's just revert to the original. Because there's a different approach to tracing in Illustrator. Now, first of all, we are going to embed this, and then also you have to do two things. So you have to count the squares. You have to know the number of squares in it, and you see the number of lines and columns. And then also you have to crop this quite exactly. So this is not really exact, but it's sufficient. If you don't have that, so you can use the crop image function. But I have counted this, it's 29 by 29. So let's go to Object, Create Object Mosaic. And then what we can do is enter the number of tiles, which is 29. It's already in here. What I'm going to show you is if it isn't, you enter a number in one of those and then use the ratio to have the other one auto completed. And then you can, of course, delete the raster, but I would first keep it so you can compare. So let's just go to OK. And there is now the duplicate, which is vectorized. And let's go to the recolor artwork function. And let's just set this to blue. And then let's select this and go to multiply. And you see, it matches. Hooray, this was a great approach. It's exact. These are all squares. If you want to, you can use Pathfinder functions to actually unite them. So you could go to the Pathfinder and select Merge here, and then based on the color, they will be united, but it's not needed. So second approach, let's take a look how to do that in InDesign. In InDesign, I have already created a document, so let's go to Object, Generate QR Code. Of course, you have to know what's inside that QR code, because you have to recreate it. You have to choose which option it is. So mine was a web hyperlink, and I have entered my website address here, and it's still in the options because I have already created it once. So let's click on OK, and there you have the QR code. This looks quite well already. That's because I have turned on Overprint Preview. If you don't have that turned on, then it looks very, very bad, and you will be just kind of shocked. But actually, you can go to Overprint Preview, and then it looks beautiful. It's Vector, it's an embedded EPS, and you can even copy it over to Illustrator. So just select it, copy it. So let's go to Edit, Copy, and then let's switch to Illustrator. And then inside Illustrator, you can just paste it. There it is. And in the outline view, you can see these are all perfect vector shapes, and this is perfect, ready to use. So That's how you go about recreating a QR code in Illustrator or InDesign.